Abu Muhammad's question is pertaining a Sawun hadith in which the Prophet ﷺ said, لَوْلَا أَنْ أَشُقَّ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِي لَأَمَرْتُهُمْ بِالسِّوَاكِ مَعَ كُلِّ صَلَاةٍ or قَبْلَ كُلِّ صَلَاةٍ before every prayer I would have ordered my ummah to use the miswak, to brush their teeth with the miswak or the brush. If I was not afraid, it would be very hard for them to do so. So he said some people believe that the prayer with the miswak will have a greater reward. Definitely, using the miswak has a great reward. And a person using the miswak whenever it is prescribed will be rewarded with the reward in this regard. But not only the miswak will determine the prayer would have a greater reward or not. Maybe a person used the miswak and he was not attentive or he did not do a proper tahara. So al-miswak is a sunnah, not a wajib. The sunnah, not a wajib. It is highly recommended. If you use it, it would add up to the reward of the salah. Because the reward for offering the prayer is not limited to the prayer itself. It is how you perform tahara, how did you recite the dua at the time of making wudu and after the wudu, whether you attended the prayer in jama'ah or not, dressed up properly and covered the awra or not, and the amount of khushu' in the salah. It's many factors all together. Somebody who walked further away from the masjid to the masjid will have a greater reward than a person who is next door to the masjid, as we discussed before. But the hadith encourages us to use a miswak very often, especially before offering the prayer.